Friends, today we will study shielded metal arc welding. Shielded metal arc welding. SMAW. It is abbreviated as SMAW. S stands for shielded, M for metal, A for arc, and W for welding. Shielded metal arc welding. It is also called as manual metal arc welding. Abbreviated as MMAW. MMAW or sometimes it is also written as MMA only. Yes. MMA, manual metal arc welding. So these are the names of shielded metal arc welding: SMAW, manual metal arc welding, MMAW or MMA. Sometimes it is also called as stick welding. So we will study shielded metal arc welding today. So I have written the names: SMAW, that is shielded metal arc welding, or MMAW, manual metal arc welding. Very often it is called as MMA also, manual metal arc welding, and stick welding. So these are the names of shielded metal arc welding. So you understand the basic basic working of shielded metal arc welding. For shielded metal arc welding, we need a constant current power source. We need a constant current power source. This power source is connected with the base metal. One terminal is connected with the workpiece or base metal, and the other terminal is connected with the electrode. See, these terminals, when we use in AC alternating current, the polarity keeps on changing. The polarity changes almost 100 times in a second. So when we use in AC, the polarity keeps on changing. But when we use DC direct current, one terminal acts as positive. One terminal always acts as positive and the other terminal acts as negative. So when we use in DC direct current, one terminal will act as positive and the other terminal will act as negative. So we have two configurations over here. If we connect our electrode with the positive terminal, then it will be called as DCEP. If we connect our electrode, suppose this is the positive and this is negative terminal. This one is your positive terminal and this is your negative terminal. And if the positive terminal is connected with the electrode, this is your electrode. If the positive terminal is connected with the electrode, then this will be known as this direct current electrode positive, DCEP. Here our electrode is connected with the positive terminal, hence it is known as direct current electrode positive. I hope this is clear to you. Direct current electrode positive, DCEP. This DCEP is also known as reverse polarity. This DCP is also known as reverse polarity. Means if we connect our electrode with the positive terminal, then this configuration will be known as DCEP, direct current electrode positive, or reverse polarity. And if we connect our electrode with the negative terminal, then we'll call it as DCEM. Suppose instead of positive, this terminal is of negative, and now this terminal will act as negative and this terminal will act as positive. Suppose, and our negative terminal is connected with the electrode, then this setup will be called as DCEN, direct current electrode negative. This setup will be called as direct current electrode negative. Our electrode is connected with the negative terminal of the power source, hence it will be called as direct current electrode negative. This DCEN is also known as straight polarity. DCEN is also known as straight polarity. So I hope this is clear to you, what is DCEN and what is DCEP. DCEN is direct current electrode negative, means our electrode is connected with the negative terminal of the power source, hence it will be called as DCEN. And DCEP, direct current electrode positive, is when our electrode is connected with the positive terminal, then it will be called as direct current electrode positive, that is reverse polarity. So DCEN is our straight polarity and DCEP is our reverse polarity. See what happens when our electrode is connected. Let me explain this diagram. This is our electrode. First, this is our constant current power source. These are the two cables or leads. One cable and the other cable. One cable is connected with the workpiece and the other cable is connected with the electrode. One cable is connected with the workpiece, that is base metal, and the other cable is connected with the electrode. Now this is your electrode. This is your electrode holder. Sorry. One terminal is connected with the electrode holder, and the electrode holder holds the electrode. This is your electrode. Electrode holder, electrode. This is our electrode holder, and it holds the electrode. And our electrode is a flux coated electrode. It's a flux the electrode which we use in SMAW is a flux coated electrode, means the solid wire of the electrode is coated with the flux. Here we can see the inner portion is our solid wire. This is our electrode, and it is covered, and it is covered with the flux. This electrode is covered with the flux. This electrode is covered with the flux. So this is our electrode holder. This is our electrode, and this is your base metal. This is your base metal, and this is your solidified weld metal. Solidified weld metal. Our travel is from this side. This is already solidified. This is your weld metal, and this portion is your molten weld pool. So what happens when we connect our electrode with the positive terminal, that is DCEP. In case of DCEP, the electrode acts as positive and the workpiece is connected with the negative terminal. In DCEP, two-third of heat is concentrated at the tip of the electrode. Two-third of the heat is concentrated at the tip of the electrode. I will write it down. in DCEP, direct current electrode positive, 2/3 of the heat is concentrated at the tip of the electrode. 2/3 of the heat is concentrated at the tip of the electrode. And in the case of DCEM, that is when our electrode is connected with the negative terminal, in case of DCEM, 2/3 of heat is concentrated. In case of DCEM, direct current electrode negative, 2/3 of our heat is concentrated at the workpiece. At the workpiece, 2/3 of electrode is concentrated at the workpiece. So I hope you, the DCEM and DCEP is clear to you. See, when we need a better penetration, when we need a deeper penetration, or when we are using a thicker metal, then this DCEP is required. Because if we have to penetrate a thicker material, this DCEP setup is required. And mostly in shielded metal arc welding, we use DCEP only. DCEP. Mostly. Sometimes we use DCEM also, but mostly we use DCEP. That is, our electrode is connected with the positive terminal, and our workpiece is connected with the negative terminal. So this is about the basic setup of SMAW: constant current power source, electrode cable or leads, electrode holder, our electrode, and the base metal. This is the basic setup. Now I'll explain the working, how the arc is ignited. I'll explain how the arc gets ignited and how welding is done. To initiate the arc, electrode is made to strike the workpiece. Electrode is touched with the workpiece. Suppose this is your workpiece and this is your electrode. This is your workpiece and this is your electrode. Electrode, workpiece. First, this electrode is touched. This electrode is touched with the workpiece. This electrode is touched with the workpiece. When we touch the electrode with the workpiece, arc ignites. Arc is generated. When we touch the electrode with the workpiece, arc is generated. Soon after the generation of the arc, this electrode is withdrawn from the workpiece. Soon after generation of the arc, initiation of the arc, this electrode is withdrawn from the workpiece, but it remains within a close distance. See, soon after the generation of the arc, soon after the initiation of the arc, this electrode is withdrawn from the workpiece. It is lifted up from the workpiece. It is lifted from the workpiece, but remains in close contact with the workpiece. It remains within the close contact of the workpiece. See what happens. When we touch or when we strike the electrode with the workpiece, arc ignites. And that arc produces certain gases. That arc immediately produces certain gases. And when we withdraw the electrode from the workpiece, this gap between the workpiece and the electrode gets filled with the gases. This gap gets filled with the gases. These gases are ionized. See, these gases are ionized. And we know that in ionized gases, flow of electrons takes place. Though our electrode and workpiece are not in contact, not in physical contact, but this gap is filled with the ionized gases, and hence within the ionized gases, flow of electrons always takes place. Means in spite of not in physical contact with the workpiece, this entire circuit remains closed or energized, and flow of electrons takes place. In spite of
just with the workpiece. I'll explain once again. As I told you earlier, electrode is connected with the one terminal of the workpiece, one terminal of the power source, and workpiece will be connected with the other terminal of the power source. To initiate the arc, this electrode is striked. This electrode is touched with the workpiece, and soon after striking the arc, soon after touching the electrode with the workpiece, this electrode is withdrawn. Within a fraction of a second, this electrode is touched with the workpiece and withdrawn from the workpiece. Here, like this, I've touched the workpiece and withdrawn from the workpiece, but it remains within the close contact of the workpiece. So when we touch the electrode with the workpiece, when we strike the electrode with the workpiece, the circuit gets energized. Circuit becomes closed and flow of electron starts. Flow of electron takes place and arc ignites. Soon after initiation of the arc, this electrode is withdrawn. Soon after initiation of arc, this electrode is withdrawn, but it remains within in the close contact of the workpiece. It is withdrawn but remains within close contact of the workpiece, and this gap between the electrode and the workpiece gets filled with the ionized gases. Gap between the electrode and the workpiece filled with the ionized gases, and hence flow of electrons takes place. Means in spite of not being in contact with the workpiece, the electrode not being in the contact of the workpiece, flow of electrons takes place. That is because of this ionized gases. So this is how we start the arc. We ignite the arc. I hope this is clear to you. How we generate the arc. I hope this is clear to you. Now I told you that if our electrode holder is connected with the positive, then this setup will be called as DCP, and if it is connected with the negative, then it will be called as DCE, and direct current electrode negative. See what happens in DCEP. DCEP is direct current electrode positive or reverse polarity. Reverse polarity. During DCEP, this electrode is connected with the positive terminal and the workpiece is connected with the negative terminal. Electrode is connected with the positive terminal and the workpiece is connected with the negative terminal. So flow of electrons flow to the tip of the electrode. Electrons flow to the tip of the electrode. Please remember, electron flow track from negative to positive. Hence, if our workpiece is connected with the negative, then flow of electron takes place to the tip of the electrode. The flow of electrons is to the tip of the electrode. And during DCEN, that is a straight polarity. DCEN, direct current electrode negative, that is straight polarity, our electrode is connected with the negative terminal and the workpiece is connected with the positive terminal. Workpiece will be connected with the positive terminal and the electrode will be connected with the negative terminal. So during DCEN, the electrons flow from the tip of the electrode. In DCEP, the electrons flows to the tip of the electrode, but in DCEN, the electrons will flow to the tip of the electrode in DCEN. So now have explained. So now I have explained how the arc is generated. Now I will explain how welding is done. So I will explain how welding is done. See what happens when our circuit is energized, our circuit is closed, our circuit is energized. This metal from the electrode is transferred to the workpiece in the form of So when we start the welding, the metal is transferred from the electrode to the workpiece. Metal is transferred from the electrode to the workpiece in the forms of droplets. Globular metal transfer, it is also called as globular metal transfer. The metal is transferred from the electrode to the workpiece in the form of droplets. In the form of metal droplets, small droplets of metals, it is transferred from the electrode to the workpiece. Now, as I told you earlier, that this electrode is covered with the flux. Electrode is covered with the flux. What happens? This flux also gets decomposed during welding. Flux also gets decomposed or burns during the welding, and this flux produces fumes. Flux produces fumes or gases. These fumes, they shield our weld pool. This is our weld pool. The molten weld metal, the pool of welded molten weld metal is called as weld pool. This weld pool gets covered with the fumes which are produced by the flux. So this weld pool gets shielded by the fumes that is produced by the flux, decomposition of the flux. This shielding of weld pool protects the weld pool from the external environment. Protects the weld pool from the environment. This shielding of gases protects the weld pool from the environment. That is very necessary. Why? Because if we don't shield our weld pool, then chances of weld metal getting oxidized is always there. Oxidation will take place if we do not shield our weld metal. The atmospheric oxygen present in the atmosphere will react with the molten weld metal and it will form oxides. Oxidation will take place. Hence, we shield our weld pool. How? By the flux. And one more thing. First, this flux produces fumes. Then, second thing is that our flux is lighter in density. The density of flux is lighter. Flux is lighter in density. Hence, during welding, the material of flux floats on the weld pool. Material of this flux floats on the weld pool and gets solidifies. Here you can see this layer. This is our weld metal, and the thin layer is our slag. Thin layer is our solidified flux. This is our weld metal, and this is our solidified flux. It is also called as solidified slag. And since it is lighter in density, hence this flux comes upward, this flux floats on the weld pool and forms a very thin layer of slag. This forms a very thin layer of slag. It also helps in this thin layer of slag also helps in slow metal slow transfer of it also helps in slow transfer of heat. What happens if our weld pool if our molten weld metal gets solidified very rapidly? If it solidified rapidly, then microstructural changes take place. If this molten weld metal if our molten metal solidifies rapidly, then microstructural changes. Microstructural change takes place and it forms martensite, which shall be avoided. Hence, this thin layer of slag helps in slow cooling of the weld metal. So we have understood the basic setup of the arc welding. Now one thing is there, power. Power is measured in volts and current. We have two terms, volts and current. So basically we measure our power in current, and that is also in amps or amperages. Amperage or amps. We measure the power of shielded metal arc welding in amps or amperage. This current current depends on the electrode diameter of the electrode dia. Normally in market we have three sizes are very common: 2.5, 3.15 and 4.0 mm dielectrode. So if we are using a thinner electrode, then we need less current as compared to a larger dia electrode. So the current depends on the electrode dia, and our current depends on the thickness of the material also. Thickness of the workpiece. If we are welding a thinner metal, then we need less current as compared to the thicker material. If you weld a thicker material, we need more current, and if we are welding thinner material, we need less current. So our current depends on the electrode dia, thickness of the material, and third one is the position of the welding. Position of the welding. Suppose we are welding flat in a flat position. If we are welding in a flat position, then we need more current as compared to welding in a overhead position. So the current depends on electrode dia, thickness of the material, and position of the material. So friends, today we understood the basic principle of shielded metal arc welding, the fluxes, the electrode, and how this welding is done, and what are the parameters to choose current. I hope you like this video. Thank you very much.